So I think the uniqueness of the idea behind the Molecular Engineering Institute at the University of Chicago is that it is truly bringing together both physical sciences and biological sciences. You know, people will say, well, we have this building where we put physicists together and biologists together. This actually happens here at the university. I'm in the Gordon Center for Integrative Science. And we do run into each other, and we do talk to each other. We have graduate programs where we're really bringing people together to have, you know, students, co-mentors across the physical and biological sciences. And so I think that that is going to be the atmosphere upon which this institute is going to be formed. And that's really going to encourage this crosstalk between the disciplines.
The university has eschewed investment in engineering for most of its history. But at this time, it sees a special opportunity to make its mark in defining a new type of engineering, molecular engineering. The idea is that the tools and the approaches of engineering at the molecular scale have changed to the point where it's very hard to see the difference between basic science, the fundamental questions about how nature works on the molecular level, and the ability to craft molecules, many of them, many building blocks together, to make useful devices and solve important societal problems.
A lot of the problems that we seek to address through the Molecular Engineering Institute have already been addressed at the biological level. And so it's one thing of understanding how these systems work in a variety of different living organisms, and then taking that knowledge from those organisms and saying, okay, well, how can we make it better? How can we make it more efficient? Or how can we make it more of a large scale? So of course we have plants that photosynthesize. They essentially take energy from actually a very small percentage of the sunlight, and they convert it into making a huge tree, for example. And that's basically energy from the sunlight that is responsible for that. So how do we harness that technology? Can we look at the photosystems that they actually use within their cells and say, oh wow, they really figured it out well. How do we then convert that to solar panels, for example? Another thing that I think is also very exciting about this institute is not just to have it be applied technologies that are coming out of this, but also studying at a more basic level, how do systems evolve, for example, creating systems that are evolvable within themselves. And again, these would have a huge variety of applications outside of just the basic research in which they are born.
And our hope, of course, is that the combination of the basic science sensibility and the engineering abilities will give a richness to the scientific endeavor at the university that we've never had before.